It's October, so there's a bunch of scary shit for us to be concerned about. The presidential debate, clowns on the loose, but me? I'm more scared about this capture card from Katsukity, which was given to me graciously by your boy KK. Thank you so much, brother. He's been watching out for me in more ways than you guys can imagine. I appreciate him. Send him some love on Twitter, wherever the hell he is. Let him know that your boy really appreciates it. This will be the fourth method of trying to capture 3DS footage that I have put into play for the entirety of my YouTube channel. When I say the name Katsukity, some of you might recognize it. They are basically a creator of 3DS capture boards, which you can use via USB connection to take footage directly from the 3DS onto your computer and record it for content creation purposes. So YouTubers, they would like something like this, but not Katsukitties nowadays. When I first purchased a Katsukity device, or rather I shouldn't say me, when my friend Ben first purchased me a Katsukity device, it was back in 2013 when I was living with him. It seemed like it was sturdy back then, but it wasn't a new 3DS. It was a regular 3DS XL. There were some technical issues with it, but I was able to record a lot of footage off of it for 3DS games for a while. And then when the 3DS got an upgrade to the new 3DS, I figured, you know what, might as well look into getting a capture card for that as well too. So I invested some more money and got another one, a second capture card. Both capture cards failed on me at the exact same time, and this came on the cusp of me hearing a bunch of rumors that the new 3DS capture cards that Katsukity made were completely borked. I mean, there were a bunch of people in the Smash community that all expressed the same thing. Don't buy these, they are absolute bullshit. And when Smash Brothers was on the 3DS, there were plenty of people that were getting into big arguments with Katsukity online, very public debates, see what I did there, about the quality of these things. And eventually, her name in the capture board industry sort of got blacklisted. There's another person who is in competition with her who goes by the name of Loopy, but he's not as consistent. Then again, consistency with her isn't really something you can claim nowadays, because to get your hands on one of these capture cards is not only going to cost you upwards of over half a grand, more like around 620 or more depending on where you live, but it will also take 6 to 8 months to get your capture card if you decide to order one of these things. And then not only that, the board itself is faulty. You won't be able to see it from this camera angle, but if you take a look at the USB port, which is used to take the footage off the 3DS, you will see that it is somewhat slanted on the inside. And my previous new 3DS XL capture card that I purchased from her for upwards of $650 had the same looking port on the back of it. So did the one that I purchased back in 2013. The new 3DS capture card was not reliable in the slightest, and for it to break a month or two after I purchased it, really hurt my morale when it came to supporting Katsukity and her development on these products. And then I thought to myself, what does this mean for the capture card quality that I purchased before? When I bought her card back in 2013-2014, my friend Ben got me it. It didn't seem like it was this faulty like the new 3DS one was, but I remember now, I didn't really use it that much. I played Pokemon X and Y, I played Fire Emblem, and those really weren't too long of a time span. But there was never a time where I was actually solidifying my usage of the 3DS capture card, the old one that I had. So if it didn't get that much use and it finally breaks, what does that say about the quality of it when I first received it? It basically means that there's something going on with her capture boards, and they're not reliable in the slightest. Whenever you purchase one of these things, it comes with a huge warning inside of the box that states, do not be rough with the cord, and make sure that you always put it in and take it out gently. Most of you fellas should be doing this anyways. Do you get the motherfucking joke? It's a sex joke. But I made sure to use the most attentive care to take care of the capture cards that I purchased and that I received from her, and every single one of them broke. So guys, we have a problem. I have this new capture card. This is fresh. It's not been used once, but I'm scared to use it because I get back into this Fire Emblem footage. We have Pokemon Sun and Moon on the horizon. This would be a great asset to my YouTube channel. But how long will it take until this bitch will break? This ain't Loopy's cards, and it's hard to get your hands on Loopy's nowadays anyways. So I'm in a tough spot right now. I wanted to ask if any of you dudes have suggestions on the way that I can use this card while preserving the faulty hardware on the inside from Katsukity as long as humanly possible. I've seen other capture methods from Nintendo directly, which use a huge, thick, like BBC cable to connect the 3DS to the actual capture board device. I don't know if I'll be able to pull off something like that, but you see how sturdy it looks, right? That's a cable that is not going to break on you, no matter how rough you are with it, unless you're extremely rough. But we don't have that potential over here with this capture card. But if you guys know any other way, something that you can put inside of the USB slot and it not move at all to upset the faulty hardware on the inside, that would be great, guys. But at this point, I'm not going to use this capture card unless I have a different approach that can help me to preserve the lifespan of it, since I need this thing for a bunch of games down the road. Suggestions are appreciated. Have fun watching the debate.